Hello friends, my name is Vivek Kumar and today I am going to give the introduction about our new model that is called Kiddos. So this is Kiddos. So previously you must have heard about the Vidoos 2.0. So this is similar to that, but of course there is a different platform to program this software, and there are some extra sensors that we previously missed in the Vidoos 2.0. So as you can see, these are the parts that we often use to make different kind of model related to this Kiddos model. So first of all, let me introduce you what are the important parts that we have to understand. So these are the basically connector parts so that we use to create our different models. So this you can identify this. This is just a motor, so which we are already familiar with this motor, as we have seen in our Vidoos 2.0. So as you can see that this is the smart hub. So you can see here, so there are certain ports to connect different sensors. So we have P1, P2, P3 and P4 to connect different sensors. At in one time you can connect 4 sensors. Then again, these are the ports where we connect the motors. So we can connect 4 motors, M4, M3, M2 and M1. And then again here by inserting the USB cable we can charge it. And here is the power button, so you can turn it on and off. So that is the basic and quick intro about the components of this kit. Now let me show you one by one what are the different sensors and the purpose of using different those sensors. So as you can see here, these are the sensors, different sensors block that we use to construct different model related to our Kiddos. So now let me show you what are those different sensors that we use. So as you can see this, these are the sensors and this is the motor. So let me introduce you. First of all, so this is the motor, you can see. So this is the connector. You can connect this motor any port of the hub. So I have already connected a motor in this model, and then we have the sensor. So you can see this is the motion sensor. Basically this is an infrared sensor, so if there is any object coming in front of it, it will act accordingly. And similarly we have blocks under our programming part that we can use to program this motion sensor. So apart from the motion sensor, you can say this is the tilt sensor. So if there is any object that is that we are tilting or turning, this will help you to detect that tilting motion. So in Vidoos 2.0 we have also used this tilt motion. So this is the tilt motion, and that was the motion sensor. Apart from this, we have a simple RGB part. So actually there is a RGB bulb connected to it, so you can use in different model to glow a bulb. So that is the basically RGB LED part that we use to glow an LED. Apart from this, we have the RGB block. As you can see here, there are three bulbs. So we have multiple colors under the programming part, so you can use accordingly. So at the same time you can glow 3 different colors of the bulb because there are 3 LED attached to it. So apart from this, we have an extra sensor. So let me show you. So this is the gyro scale sensor. So what is the working of gyro scale sensor? Actually it detects the black and white colors. So you can see in the programming part I can take any color, and according to my selected color it will sense that color. And if the sense the desired color, then it will act accordingly, that I can program by using the relevant block. So this is all about the different sensors, motors and hub that we can use to construct different models. Now there is an important point that we need to understand is how to connect this to our laptop. So for this, first of all, you'll have to make the power on button, and since it is connected through the Bluetooth, so you are supposed to have a Bluetooth adapter that will be inserted in the USB port of your laptop. And when you will insert it, you can see the LED is glowing here, and here if you have started your hub, it will also start glowing an LED. So let me show you how to connect it. So first of all, I have already opened it. So once you have opened your software, you have just click here, and once you'll click here, you have to select the port on which your adapter is connected. So in order to know on which port exactly your adapter is connected, you can go to your device manager and you can see what exactly the port number is. So in my case, it is port number 7, COM 7. So let me show you. If it is connected, it will show me yes, it is connected. So just click here, and this is how you can connect with your laptop or computer. So basic step is how to start your first programming. So as you can see, once you will open the software, that is Kidoz software, so here is an icon coming, plus icon, so where you can click and you can, that is the play button. So you can see here, this is the play button, and we have icons for the motors, weight block for the motors, that is for the stopping motors, then RGB and the bulb, LED, sound, picture, size, and these weight block, these are the important blocks. Apart from this, the message block, music block, and these are the sensors. So let me show you. If I pick the motor block, so here M1 is the port on which you will be connecting your motors. So whatever the port you are using, you just mention it. So how, if here M1 is written, how can change it? By clicking on it, M2, M3, M4. Secondly, if you are using some sensors, like, let me show you. This is the weight block. It means it will wait for the second which you select from here. So suppose it is going to wait for the 13 second. So this is how you can define how long the wait block has to wait for any command. Apart from this, you can also use the different sensors here. For example, let me use the gyro scale sensor, as you can see here. So here is the P1. So you can choose any port where you have connected your sensor. You just have to mention. If you have to change the P1, then just click on it. It will be automatically changed. Second thing, here is the different cases of the sensor. Like in the case of gyro scale sensor, I have selected the white color. It means it will detect the white color, and if it detects the white color, it will start accordingly. Like I have selected a motor, so it will start moving in the anti-clockwise direction at the speed of 3. So one more important thing is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In case of motor, this indicates the level of speed of the motor. So if I select the 8, it will start at faster speed. If I select 1, it will start moving at the slower speed. So this is the basic thing, how can you can program it. Second thing, if you click on this icon, you will see different examples or different models. So let me show you how a model works. So if you click here, you can see here, that is the basic model, and similarly we have so many models that you can select from there. And now if you click here on this icon, let me show you. So it starts showing the building instructions. So if you have to go to next step of the building instruction, just click here. You can see here. So here is the building instruction. So by following all the instructions, you can build your own model. Now again, if I'll click here, you can go to the programming part. So for that model, you can just copy and paste this programming part, or alternatively, you can keep this pop-up opened, and from here you can just start typing your code. So this is how you can use the example icon. This is how you can build a new model. Similarly, if you click on this icon, this will show different type, different applications of the many blocks that has been given in the Kidoz software. So you can see here, stop motor, how you can stop the motor, how can you increase the speed, how can power give the power to the motor, how can move the motors in different direction. Similarly, how can you use RGB block, how can blink RGB block, how can you make it traffic light project. You can see here, so sequence of images, display size of image. So there are so many examples that you can use to explore the various options and various components of the KiDOS software. So let me select any one of these, like I am selecting this. So you can see steps are coming, you just have to see and select your on block play button. Then it has taken the loop, so I can select the loop icon from here. And then it is taking the motor block, so you can select your motor block. And then there is a sensor connected to it, accordingly you can select your out sensor block. So this is how you can program. So once you have written or selected a program, that program will be showing here. So you don't need to save it explicitly, it will automatically get saved at this icon. And you can, if you can click it and go to the that program. So in this video I have shown you about how to connect your hub with the laptop, what are the different sensors, what are the different other important components, and what are the different blocks, how to go to the example blocks, how to find the building instructions, and how to save your program, and how to write a basic program in the KiDOS software. So this is all about the introduction part of the KiDOS kit or model. Thank you very much.